let's move on to our third main topic today. And our third main topic today gets submitted to us by Angel A, who writes, "Hey, John and crew. So I just saw that Deadline is reporting that Woody Harrelson is going to be replacing the role recently departed by Jason Statham in The Man from Toronto. I think Harrelson is a great replacement for Statham, and I was just wondering what your thoughts are on this new casting, or if you think Statham would have been better. Thanks, and bring on the filthy." All right, thanks a lot for sending that in, Angel. And yes, I got very excited. Some of you guys might remember this. A couple weeks ago, I got very excited when they announced that Jason Statham and Kevin Hart were reteaming again after recently being in Hobbs and Shaw together to do a comedy called The Man from Toronto, an action comedy. And I was very excited about it. I thought these two would have good chemistry, and I was pumped. However, then, Jason Statham, just like a few weeks before production was supposed to begin, abruptly departed. Now, this is what comes to us from The Hollywood Reporter. Statham was in talks to star opposite Hart, but abruptly backed out a week ago. The action star was insisting on making an R-rated film, but Sony execs didn't budge in their belief in making it a broader four-quadrant movie. With his deal still not signed, Statham exited, leaving Sony now facing a production that was only six weeks from shooting in the lurch. So clearly, Statham thought they were going to do one kind of movie. Sony thought they were going to do another kind of a movie. They started butting heads. They couldn't work out what they wanted to do with it. Statham decided, and that's fair. That's fine. It's totally fine that Sony wanted to stick to their guns. It's totally fine that Statham did with his, and so they parted ways on that. But I was very disappointed. I was very disappointed when I found that out. So now, what they're telling us is that Woody Harrelson has stepped in to replace Jason Statham in the movie. What do I think about this? Okay, here's the thing, Rob. I am a big Jason Statham fan. But I will tell you, Woody Harrelson is the better actor. Statham's great. I love Statham. Woody Harrelson is an Academy-level actor. Not that he's got tons of mantles, trophies on his mantles, but he's been in the discussion many times. He is the better overall actor. Statham would have been better for this movie. Because unless we see the movie and it's not what I'm expecting, if this is an action comedy, you get Jason Statham because he is an action star. He can do the martial arts. He can do these action sequences. He can make something feel gritty and intense and great and fun, much like he did in Hobbs and Shaw. He can bring that physicality. And while I'm not saying Woody Harrelson is rolling around in a wheelchair, he is just not capable of pulling off the stuff that Jason Statham can. So while I believe Woody Harrelson is the better actor, and in many other, if we were talking about a lot of different other movie projects, I would go, yeah, Woody Harrelson's probably the better choice. In a film like this, if it's going to be the type of movie that it sounds like it's going to be, where it's like an action comedy, I really do think Jason Statham probably would have been the better guy. But listen, Rob, I'm always saying it's never a bad idea to add talent, and it's never a bad idea to add a guy like Woody Harrelson to your movie. So, hey, listen, if you got to replace him, you got to replace him. Woody Harrelson's great. I love seeing him on screen. But until I see the movie and the movie turns out to be different than what I thought it was going to be, I'll probably still think Statham probably would have been the better fit. Rob, you hear about this. Statham's gone. Harrelson's in. How are you feeling about it?
Well, you know, it seems to me like if you have Jason Statham, you don't have a gun. You don't pull a gun, John, unless you're going to use it. And Jason Statham is a gun. You know, you pull Jason Statham out. You want him to bust heads. You want him to kick some ass. Now, I understand he's been in movies. I mean, the Fast and the Furious franchise, things like that, where it can be more PG, but I think Statham wants to be unleashed. He wants to go back to doing something kick-ass. And if he's going to do a comedic take on it, I mean, he's the man from Toronto. I mean, how mean can he be, really? But I think that you want to see, I want to see him breaking arms and legs and kicking ass. And I can understand he has his image to protect as well. And I think that when you look at movies like say a Deadpool or I think after doing the fun stuff like Hobbs and Shaw and like the Fast and Furious movies, he wants to go back and do something where he really brings out, he's unleashed. Statham unleashed. That's what he wants now. He wants to do something where blood's going to hit the wall. And I don't think that would happen in a PG-13 movie. I get where he's coming from. You know, Woody Harrelson's more of a funny guy. Like you said, he's probably a much defter actor. But it depends. If they don't want to make a movie where blood's hitting the wall, I get it. I understand why he left. I don't think that means it's going to be bad, though. I think Woody Harrelson can really deliver. I love Woody Harrelson. And when you get peak Woody Harrelson, it's a lot of fun.
Can you think of anybody else that maybe might have been a better replacement for a Jason Statham type in a movie like this?
Michael Dudikoff, the American Ninja. Of course, he's probably 70 years old by now. No, I mean, right off the top of my head, I don't know, man. Who can fight like him?
And have that style and those moves and the comedic chops. Yeah,
Jeff Speakman.
I mean, yeah, Jeff Speakman. Look, I love Woody Harrelson. It's as good as a replacement as any, I guess. I'm going to lament that we don't have Jason Statham there, because it just seems like the kind of movie for him. Question is, guys, how do you feel about it? Jump on down to the comments section below and let us know your thoughts. All right.